has some bus. It is 8 liter. Hopefully, we will have wisdom 10.5 meter bus. Okay. We have sensors that have 5 lidars in the corners, 128 channel top, 432 channel in the corner, which we have replaced in new generation vehicles to 64 channel. And we have 8 RGB cameras located in the main station of bus. We have 2 thermal cameras, basically to differentiate live objects from the physical objects.
Yeah.
We have GNSS receiver. For emergency brake, sonic sensor. So this is our sensor suite here. And we have Avastec's Flow Ride AI, level 4 autonomous driving software platform. So we fuse the sensor data and we operate autonomous level 4 on the public transport road. Okay. So now let's have a demo drive. If you have any questions, please ask us. Now let us get in the bus, see on the demo. Okay?
Yeah.
Please, James.
Please.
Yeah. Arkadaşlar, are you ready?
Okay. 这个也还是配置，配备了这个按照这个要求，还是有价，它可以根据这个需要来取消，不用这个。这个呢就是在CASA的ETAC这个基础上来做的。所以说我们也看到是一个滴滴版的车，然后呢这个后面有两座，但是它做的非常的这个巧妙的这样一个形态。好，那么我们也看到这里有残疾人的这个座椅。
The bus is 22 seating passengers, 4 master seats, standing passengers, so 50 plus person. We have disabled location here, and that marks our complete system is located there. This is first generation bus, so it's a big one. In other generations, it is more small, okay. And this one is roadshow bus in the exhibition. This is GRE. Next week we will be in RNTK in France. End of October we will be in Global Mobility in Madrid. So this is demo bus. At the moment our speed is 40 kilometers per hour, which is for in-city public transportation, 300 kilometers is fair enough. In Hong Kong Road, we need charge this vehicle in 2 days at a time. So it is quite convenient, okay? So now, yes, we will switch on autonomous mode, and in this fair exhibition, they have provided us a road, which now we are in. You may take your video from here also.
Yeah.
You see, so we are in the public road. Anything may happen.
Yeah.
You see, the pedestrians are crossing, and the system is recognizing the pedestrians. And once convenient, the system, would you please hold somewhere?
这是在展馆的后门这个地方的话，就是说有很多的观众正在入场，所以说在这种复杂，算是比较复杂的这种停车场的环境当中，它可以比较自由的，就是像一个熟练的驾驶人在这样一种操作。
At the moment, if that has passed our maximum speed is 25 km per hour based on the regulation in the fairground street.
停车场的另外一个角落了。
You may notice that the driving is quite smooth, not like shuttles.
这就是在没有障碍的环境下，它在行走。 转弯到路口，就是需要停车场区的一个转弯。这是在实际的道路上，在行走这个展馆的停车场里边的。 车辆也在进出，人也在横穿。这个他对周边的判断是否很准确，不是靠一个简单的这个视觉判断。好，我小柯。今天是第一个开放日，说现在是10:30，估计上午这个游客会大量的来到，因为布鲁塞尔人这个夜生活比较多，早上都可能还在家里，这个展馆还没有这个塞满人。另外一个方向就是说，展馆的前面是这个公共交通的线路，这边呢是后面，就是五号馆后面这个停车场。就是私人开车来的这个选择，就在欧洲我们看到公共交通跟这个私人交通都在共同的这样去申请，当然它这个比例啊环境呢是稍有不一样的。
好，
那么我们相当于进入另外一个主干道了，就是相当于展馆停车场的主干道，两边都停满了车。这个就是刹车，前面有车通过，避让车辆。
arkadaşlar
durduktan sonra bir sonra daha gitti. Burası sonra gitti. 这也就是我们所说的 L 四级的那个全无人的这种状态。这就是原来的属于巴士的那个停车站，现在被另外一个小汽车所占用，所以说在这个时候他都让前面那个车离开，他才能够停到他的这个车位。因为我们讲这个公共交通是在这个固定的线路上行走，就是说这个停靠站就是预设的，就是说跟这个道路通过道路是稍有是不一样的，所以说像这种状态下来讲的话，那么我们说如果没有法律的这么一种强化，比如说公交车站那么被人占用，那么可能就会带来了这么一个这个无人驾驶的这个实际的运营会受到干扰啊。当然这个讲到这个无人驾驶这个未来的这种应用的这种场景，那么这个就是讲它会受到这么一些因素的这个干扰。好，这是在今天这个体验过程当中，我们说它是第四个这种运营的这种体验。好，我们这个体验的这个过程就基本结束。
那么我们又回到了这个我们出发点的这个场站这个位置，这里来看到的。好 ，OK，OK。Okay, okay.
Engine, please open. Okay,
near the station.
Yeah.
Okay. 好，就是精准回到这个车站这个定靠的位置。OK。Open the door. 啊，绿板门。说这么一个绿板门在家这个状态下 ，All right。好，那么我们说今天这个喀桑的这个自动驾驶车的这个乘坐的体验，那么就结束了。